Hello, Space Cats, and welcome back to my channel. Space, it's expensive, but what has space ever done for you? I mean, when people usually think about space, they think about astronauts, about the International Space Station, and sometimes about the moon. But actually, there is so much more to space than just that. NASA's publication spin-off lists over 2,000 applications of space that are used in our everyday lives. That is a lot to cover in this video, but at least in this video, I'm going to try and cover 20 different space applications that have benefited you. Number one, CT or CAT scanners are probably something that you've come across before if you've ever been to a hospital. They use x-rays to make detailed images inside of the body so that we can detect things like tumors. But their history dates back to pre-Apollo days when they were originally used to find defects in rocketry components. Number two, camera phone technology. These originate from compact technology developed for satellites. The CMOS detectors are nowadays found in everything from mobile phones to digital cameras. Number three, winglets. You know, the turned up ends of the wings of aircraft? These are not just for decoration. Originally, they were developed by NASA to reduce the drag on aircraft, essentially reducing the cost of fuel for every flight by about 10%. So you can thank NASA for the 10% discount you have on your flights. Number four, colored LED lights. These were developed for astronauts to help them sleep better on the International Space Station, but now they've been brought back down to Earth to help humans, animals, and plants. Number five, Nike Air Trainers. These were developed by a former NASA employee, and they're based on technology used by astronauts in their spacesuit. Number six is water purification systems. They were developed to help recycle water on board of the International Space Station, but nowadays they can be found in most swimming pools. Number seven, memory foam mattresses. Memory foam was developed to make the seats on board of the space shuttle more comfortable for astronauts during takeoff and landing. Number eight, handheld vacuum cleaners. They were developed to extract dust and rocks from the surface of the moon. That's a bit different from the dust and biscuit crumbs that we have here on Earth. Number nine is the cochlear implant. It's used by over 300,000 people all over the world with hearing problems. And the implant was originally developed by a NASA engineer who himself had hearing problems. He didn't have any medical experience, but he based the design on engineering principles of the inner ear. Number 10 is duct tape. These were designed to protect electrical instrumentation coils and fluid lines from the conditions experienced at rocket launch during blastoff. Number 11 is computational translation software. Have you ever used Google Translate? I know myself, I was so reliant on it when I was living in Spain. But the earliest two-way translation software was actually developed to translate Russian to English and vice versa for the Apollo Soyuz and all the literature and the manuals that were involved. Number 12 is aerial imaging, and it was developed by two NASA engineers to help a company visualize pipelines and power lines for maintenance and for planning. Number 13 is global positioning systems, or GPS. These were first used on those aerial imaging satellites to match up the images to their locations. Number 14 is baby formula. Whilst examining the dietary needs of astronauts, NASA concocted a multivitamin regimen and discovered a natural source for an omega-3 fatty acid. These are now included in 90% of baby formula on the market and also other dietary supplements. Number 15 is wireless communication, and this was developed so that astronauts could avoid getting tangled up in wires whilst in space. The technology has since been adopted in mobile phones and WLAN. So for example, you might have them in your schools linking all the school computers together. Number 16 is cloud computing. NASA developed OpenStack cloud computing, which was a breakthrough for cloud computers. It allowed them to scale massively. Number 17 is PTFE fabrics. Flexible, strong material that you typically find on the roofs of football stadiums, on a lot of durable tents. Actually, they're used all over, from malls to museums. But the material was actually originally made for spacesuits to make them lightweight, very strong, and very flexible. Number 18 is the heart pump, and anyone who has ever had to wait around for a heart transplant will be very familiar with how crucial and how life-saving this technology is. But did you know that the technology is actually based off fluid flow through rocket engines? 19 is the anti-gravity treadmill, and it's used by professional athletes, but also people who have undergone surgery and are learning to walk again. Originally, it was developed for astronauts so that they could work out in the International Space Station. Number 20 is roller coasters. Well, not the roller coasters themselves, but nowadays many roller coasters are built using a software called Nastran. And this was built by NASA engineers to perform structural analyses. The idea is that they want to make the roller coaster as safe as possible, but not overly strong, because that would use a lot of steel and also make it very expensive. So that's just a small fraction of the huge number of applications space has done for us. I'll link NASA's spin-off website down below so you can check out some more. In the meanwhile, if you like my video, don't forget to leave me a like, share, and subscribe.